Here we are at the beginning of the third video, and I'd like to describe the rest of this work for you. I'm going to start by putting an indentation on the side of the tank here, and then we'll angle the indentation in slightly and start to fillet the edges to soften it. We're going to do the same thing up on the top and have a little indentation on the top. And then we'll put the big fillets on all the way around, and we'll also put on the small fillets. Then we'll mirror the tank and put a gas filler on top, and we'll take a volume for the entire tank since that will be important. So let's get started on the indentation on this side of the tank. I'll start with, of course, sketching on this side. So let's open a new sketch on this plane. And this sketch will have just kind of an artistic shape. One thing I need to know is that sketching from this point of view, I want to be able to see the edges on the other side of the tank. So what I'm going to do here is turn on, under the views and appearances, I'm going to turn on the show hidden edges. And this allows me to see the other side of the tank. And so I can judge where I need to put this sketch. All right, so let's put in an arc edge here, and another arc edge here, and we'll put an arc edge also right here, and then I'm going to switch using the L key to a line just to draw a straight line between these two points. I'm not going to use any dimensions, because here it's more of the visual shape that matters than the actual dimensions. Now I can see that I've messed this up a little bit, and remember that 80% of your CAD work usually turns out to be edits rather than creating things from scratch. So I'm gonna grab this endpoint and drop it onto the other endpoint. What I want to do here is to project this sketch onto the face on the other side. So I'm actually going to get out of this sketch to project it. And I'll select the sketch from the items list and swing around and shift select this face. This gives me a few options, and one of these options is project. And from here, we can see the projection of that sketch onto this face. We can go through and make some edits if we need to. So I'll go ahead and do that. Click on the sketch. And I just want to grab this endpoint and drag this down. You can appreciate how easy the editing is in Shapr 3D when you can grab your sketch and edit it and watch the 3D geometry update immediately. Okay, that's exactly what I want. Now, the next thing that I want to try is to angle this face into the model slightly to make a little indentation. But that indentation will be deeper on this end than it will be over here. So what I'm going to do is to create first a construction axis and use the type through two points and use these two points to make that axis. And I'll say done. Now the next thing I want to do is to angle in this face slightly. But I can't do it directly because there are no supporting faces around the outside. So what I want to do then is to just take this face and offset it to the inside slightly. So I'll grab that and pull it in, but I'll say a minimal amount of, say, 0.01. And now I can use the transform to rotate around an axis, rotate this face, select next, and using this axis from the items list. And now I can grab this face and rotate it down. It only rotates in increments of 5 degrees, so I'm going to just key in my 1.5 target angle, and there I am. That's the end of part 3 video. Part 4 will come back and add more detail to the tank.